Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. It's never been easier to manage tests at scale than with Xray Test Management. Xray is a Jira native software test management app that ensures your testing and development teams are collaborating to achieve the highest quality products. With Xray, you'll never deliver broken or untested code again. Xray is a comprehensive test management solution that uses Jira native issue types to specify, organize, plan, and execute tests. With Xray, you can create your tests and add preconditions, organize them using the test sets or the test repository, plan your test strategy, and finally execute tests and report the status. Before we start talking about how to generate documents, we need to understand what exactly a document is all about when it comes to the Xray. Now, Xray has capability of populating different reports and building up the dashboards using the gadgets. But what if you want a document like written reports rather than graphs and charts and data tables? So, this document generator is basically to populate theoretical reports of different activities that you perform throughout Xray. And these could be beneficial information, like a deliverable could be another artifact to prepare test progress reports and even sometime test summary reports for a particular iteration, or maybe for a particular release. These are not something which you use quite often, but never know. If you must share a test progress report occasionally, then this could be a very time-saving concept for you. Let's have a look at how exactly we get started. The document generator option can be found in the project settings. Once again, that is under the extra settings. Let's navigate to project settings in your project, and you will be having a section called as apps, where you have the Xray installed. You'll have a dedicated Xray settings tab here. Just click on this again, and here you will find the option of document generator. So, the document generator option must be configured before you can start using it. For example, let's click on Document Generator here, and you will find that there are no templates available. You can install Xray templates from the template store given that you have Xray with you, however not licensed right now. But you can certainly have licensed one copy in your organization, and you can look forward to uploading if you have already some templates with you, or look forward to going to the store. Let's click on the store here and see what we have got for us. Right now, here there will be a lot of templates available for you, for example test run details, test report, test plan basic with cover page, test plan advanced with cover page, which you can also find a detailed instruction right below this to understand what exactly will be different between a basic and the advanced one. For example, here the basic one size. This template creates a report from the test plan showing its details and a table of test run execution. Whereas in this one, you can see test run details, test step details, attachments, evidence, and defects as well. Let's install this one. Sounds interesting. Click on install, and this particular template will be installed on your Xray instance. We got a confirmation right here that it is ready. Following that, if you would like to do continuous on the same, you can also do that. For example, let's look forward to requirement traceability matrix. Right under each of the template, you would see how many people have downloaded this so far, which means talk about the popularity of that traceability or that particular document template. Click on install here, and you see that there are so many templates available. So, you may look forward to understanding what is best suited for you. Let's pick up another one as well, and that's it. I think we are good to go, and let's close this. Close this, and we have got three documents available with us: requirement traceability matrix, test execution advance, and test plan advance. All you must do is you can just click on these settings icon right here on the right side and say download, right? If you want to add more templates, you have the add button here, or click on the store button here. The add button will take you back to the three options that you can upload it with any other option. Right, you can drag and drop. So, earlier you saw that there were three options. You had the upload function, you had the add function, and you had the configure function. Right? Here we will use the add function in our store. If you want to add more now, let's click on download here, and let's have a look. Yes, you can see that there's a Word document being downloaded, and that's ready to be seen. Let's click on this file and see what exactly does it look like. And what is my report? Oh, that looks very interesting, right? And you can just say enable editing here so you can filter it out, or you can configure these parameters in the configuration of the documentation, which I'll show you in some time. And you can even have this clause like this, or confidential reports and so on, right? And you will have a title, the picture, amazing picture. There you will have some details available for the links, etc. And you will have the details required. But I think again, it's just that. Because we did not have proper traceability done, it does not show me much information. Anyway, let's see if we are having something more to say. So, let's see the test plan here. Let's see download, and let's click on this. What do we see? Again the same thing or but pretty much more detailed. We got 10 pages here, and has got a table of content with all the information what we need, and it has command, description, issue, attachment, precondition, parameters, and very detailed information, which you see the past update. But there are a lot of parameters. If you see, it's all empty, right? This was instead of giving me the details of every single execution, it is giving me some kind of references, which are empty, right? So it is not able to read that. What exactly it is? Let's try figuring it out and try fixing it. So, let's go to edit button here and see what exactly is looking forward to. Here is the name. Here is the description. If you want, you can configure and edit that. You can look forward to the scopes like issue details, or if you drop down you want to release this issue, navigator, test repository board, test plan board, etc., to include, right? You can also see the output formats to be in docs or PDF. If you can include the entities like the issue types, which you want to import, and page breaks, etc. So, you can pretty much configure, and default format can be defined here. Let's click on save. So that's pretty much what we can set it up as, and you can look forward to downloading these reports accordingly, right? It's all looking good, and I think we have the information. Let's download this report and see how it looks like. Okay, that's another one, and it has the information about the same. So, we need to pause the details and check out that how exactly the reports can look like. And we can have the runs name and other things as parameters to be defined. Now given that your report is now ready with the configurations and the parameters, it's time for us to start downloading the information and see how exactly we can download single and multiple reports. Let's go back to the project and go to any particular test. For example, we got issues. So, we do have three templates. We have executions, we have traceability, and we do have the test plan. Let's pick up a test plan here and see what we can do about it. So just because you have got information for the Xray, you have option right here onto the three dots, which is ellipsis.xray, document generator. In this test plan we just have one test to do. Let me check another test plan, which is MFP44, and I guess here we have two executions, or two tests, with different results. Oh great, we have more. Let's try exporting this as a single issue, right? It's exporting a single issue in the Xray document generator. Let's see what exactly does. And they're asking you the template. What template do you want to follow? So, we got some, you know, project templates which are created. I would say, I want the test plan advanced with the cover. Or you do have some other options, which you can pick it up, which is default, right? PDF or Word? I want PDF. Click on export, and let's have a look how exactly the document looks like, and does it really make sense to us this time. So, click on download. The file is now downloaded. Let's click on this and view it. We got the project name. So earlier if you saw that we got the template, which was not having any kind of real information, but had the parameters declared there. But this time the parameters are replaced with the real value when you exported it. The project name, my project prepared by so-and-so, the issue ID is this. And there's also a QR code with the confidentiality. And if you scroll through, now you will not see any kind of parameters, but you will see exactly the details of the test plan. And everything is being given with the percentage parameters, the test summary, etc. Wow, that looks amazingly nice, right? You can look forward to submitting this report to anyone and give great outputs to any organization. So, this is how you can populate great reports other than the graphs and the charts using Xray. That looks so nice. Anyways, that was one of the examples. That was with single issue. If you wanted to export like test plan, which is an epic at the testing level, and many things can be brought together. What if I want to do multiple things at the same time? The journey begins with applying a filter, right? Because you may not be interested in everything, what you have here. You might be interested to pull out something specific. You may carry out a criteria-based filter. Or you may even say, for example, I'm interested to pull only the kind of tests. Or you can say I'm interested only in test executions. So you can just filter out whatever you're interested in. Or you can just pull out the, you know, various tests, which you have created, right? So let me put off the test execution here. Let's put up the test, which may have different, or maybe same answers. Let's import it, right? Given that you know already that it is there you are trying to import. So, in this case, when you want to export multiple items, the question was, how to do it for single issue and multiple issues? In terms of single issue, you directly go to issue and do that from ellipsis. But for the multiple items, you'll find an Xray button here on the top, right? Let's click on this, and the pretty much same options will come, but this time for multiple issues. That is, hey, what you want to do? Do you want to do a traceability matrix, or do you want to just populate a test report? Let's see the traceability matrix, how does it look like, and if you want to have a page specific to component, which is more of like group by, right? So, you can do that. I would say no. That's fine. I'll not use that. Click on export. And all multiple issues can be populated as a report again. Let's download this and let's have a look. Well, again, pretty much the same. And it's just giving me the list of all the tests, right? But I think not all the tests are linked to any pretty good defect. So, it doesn't have the right information. Yeah, you may have looked forward to having maybe a test report. Let's see what exactly looks like. Instead of this, if I go with this, so it is complete. The option template depends here on the filtered item. We filter tests. Thus, we are getting test-related items. If you filter anything else like test plan or executions, you will have different templates available for you. All right, that's great. Let's quickly do this and check this one too. And this has supported the similar expected information. Now, we don't have much. It's just empty right now. This is what all about the document generator is. I know there are pretty much a lot of people who are interested to know about this, and they were trying to explore and understand what exactly document generator can do. And this tool can do amazingly lot of things. Test management shouldn't be a burden to your team. That's why over 4.5 million testers worldwide trust Xray to deliver the highest quality products faster than ever before. Break the silo between testing and development and integrate them under the same tool set with Xray for Jira. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our ISTQB, ITK, Xray and TestRail certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.